Multiplying a matrix A with a one elementary matrix performs one row operation on A. And of course, we can do this a couple of times. So we can perform a sequence of row operations of A like this. Now, let us pick row operations that reduce A to reduced echelon form. Well, that means that we can write the reduced echelon form of A as a product of some elementary matrices and A, as you will see in this video. So what's the idea? We'll start with some matrix A. And if we do one row reduction step, we obtain A1. Now we can also obtain this matrix A1 by multiplying on the left with an appropriate elementary matrix. Which one? Well, we find appropriate elementary matrix E1 by applying the same row reduction step on the identity matrix I. So we know that our matrix A1 equals E1 times A. Now, we can repeat this process. So we have our A1 equals E1 times A. And we do the second row reduction step. We find our elementary matrix E2, our second elementary matrix. We have to do this row operation on A1. So our A2 second step equals E2 times A1. However, A1 was E1 times A. So we see A2 equals E2 times E1 times A. Now, just repeat this procedure until A is in reduced echelon form. And then we see how do we find this. We continue multiplication with A3, A4, A5 until we are at the last step. So in general, our R will be EK, EK minus 1 up to E1 times A. Now, it's an explicit example. So we have our matrix A over here. Let's see how we can reduce it. And from that, we can deduce our elementary matrices. Well, first, it would be good to interchange the two rows. Let's use our elementary matrix E1, which is also obtained by interchanging the two rows of the identity matrix. Then add the first row minus 2 times to the second row. Yields our second elementary matrix over here. And the result over there. Then it's convenient to add the second row 1 times to the first one. To simplify our matrix further, yields our elementary matrix E3, which is also obtained by adding the second row once to the first row of the identity matrix. And finally, multiply with minus 1/3. And do the same on the identity matrix to obtain your fourth elementary matrix. And then we have row reduced matrix A. And we also have kept track of what elementary matrices are needed. And now we know, because we have E1 up to E4, that we can obtain our row reduced echelon form of A by multiplying with E1, E2, E3, E4 in the correct order on the left. So this should give us the row reduced echelon form of A. No, it's the identity matrix. Well, let's check to make sure. So we have E4, E3, E2, and I write down what E1 is and what A is. Well, let's compute the product. We get a 1, 2 over here, and on the second column we get a 3 and a 3, and write down what E2 is. Copy E4, write down over here what E3 is, and compute the product. We get a 1, 0 inner product with 1, 2 gives us a 1, minus 2, 1 inner product with 2, 1 gives us 0, and 1, 0 inner product, 3, 3 gives us 3, and the other one minus 3, so then we are over here. And finally, compute this product and write down what E4 is. Over here we have the product, and times E4, we indeed obtain the identity matrix. So you see, indeed, you can obtain the row reduced echelon form of A by doing the row reduction steps, keep track of what elementary matrices you get, and then you can get the same result by multiplying with the elementary matrices on the by multiplying A with elementary matrices on the left. You may wonder, of course, but what's the use of this? Because we already had the row reduced echelon form of A. Well, that's what you will learn in later videos when we'll start to move towards the inverse of matrices.